Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I am going to share with you how to make this easy detox lentil soup. Wait till you taste it. It is absolutely delicious, full of flavor and very hearty and also very light at the same time. It's great for the winter, perfect for one of those cold days where you just want something warm in your belly. I'm gonna show you step by step how to make this recipe, and I'll be sure to list all the ingredients and the amounts for this recipe down in the description box below this video. But look how beautiful the ingredients are. They are exceptionally clean and good for the healing process. So let's get started on making this beautiful soup. So I've got my trusty 360 cookware. This is my soup stock pot. I absolutely love it. If you haven't taken a look at the 360 cookware yet, you really should. I have a link down in the description box where you can get a 25% off discount for this cookware. The discount code is WCE25. And I will also link two videos that I did reviewing this cookware. So we're gonna start off by adding the water to the pot, and then we're gonna start adding the vegetables so we can get them going. We're gonna start off with the onions. I used yellow onions, but you can use red onions, white onions, whatever kind of onions you want or whatever you have on hand. So I am a garlic lover, so this is about 6 cloves of garlic. You can use less, you can leave it out, you can use more. I absolutely love garlic, and sometimes I will over garlic my food, but that's okay. So next I'm going to add the carrots. I love carrots. If you're not a carrot fan, you can pick whatever other vegetable you want for this dish. So next we're gonna add the vegetable stock. What you want is either a vegetable broth or a vegetable stock, but make sure it's clean and it doesn't have any junk in it. So that means read the ingredients label. Honestly, if you want, you can just use plain water. You just might have to increase your seasonings for the soup. And then next, what we're going to do is add our rinsed lentils. And you can use whatever lentils you have on hand. I just chose the red lentils because I felt like it would be the prettiest in this soup. But if you have brown lentils, green lentils, whatever you want to use, feel free. And then you want to stir the vegetable mixture, make sure the lentils are all broken up and spread throughout the pot. And you want to make sure you turn your fire up to bring this to a boil and then turn it down to a simmer. Okay, so we've got this up to a simmer so those lentils can cook. And then I'm adding my zucchini squash. You can use whatever kind of vegetable you would like. I'm sorry about the condensation on the camera, but I'm doing the best that I can. So next we're going to add the butternut squash. I love butternut squash. This is, I think, what makes this soup feel hearty. So next we're gonna add our herbs and spices, and the list of what you should put in this soup is down below. But if you want to increase the spices, feel free to do it. Do it to your taste. I also added some lemon juice. The lemon juice just pulls all the flavors together. And then stir and make sure that you get the spices and the lemon juice well combined in the soup. Then put the lid on the soup and let it simmer for as long as it takes for your lentils to get soft, which for me was about 10 minutes. So I added the broccoli and I forgot to record that part. So add your broccoli and then take your immersion blender and start blending the chunks in the soup. And what this does is it makes the soup nice and creamy. And you also want to fish out that bay leaf. And I actually forgot to do that. But you don't want to keep the bay leaf in the soup. So blend until it's the consistency in which you like. And if you don't have an immersion blender, all you do is just take part of the soup and put it in your actual blender, blend it up, and then add it back to the pot. So any chance I get to add greens, you know I'm gonna add them. So I just took a huge handful of greens and added them to the soup. And what I'm gonna do is just stir them in to the soup until they wilt. And that gives me a chance to get some greens in for the day. And all you have to do is just stir them in until they're well combined. At this point, you can turn the heat off because the soup is definitely done, and the heat from the soup being hot is what will wilt down the spinach. And if you don't like spinach, use kale, use chard, use collard greens, use whatever greens you like. And if you don't want greens in the soup, you don't have to use them at all. So now for the garnish, those lemon slices. Oh my goodness, they added so much flavor to the soup. I don't think I've ever done this before, but I'm gonna start doing it because it just pulls all the flavors together. I really wonder what this would taste like if I used lime instead of lemon. One day I'm gonna try that. So there you have it, this beautiful, easy detox lentil soup. Just serve yourself up a big, huge bowl of this. This pot makes 4 huge servings. So you don't have to feel like you're being deprived by eating this way, because you can eat as much as you want. I hope you enjoyed this video. If no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much, and I will talk to you all soon. Lots of love.